What you are looking at right now is the Santa Monica Pier, captured in 2K per eye, 90 frames per second Apple Immersive Video on my brand new Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive. In this episode, I'm putting that $32,000 cinema camera head to head with the Canon R5C with dual fisheye lens, so you can judge pure image quality inside a proper 2D 180 space. Quick reality check here before we start. The Ursa Cine Immersive isn't designed for VR 180 or any platform beyond Apple Immersive Video. And Canon EOS VR pipeline can't create Apple Immersive file. To make this comparison even possible and shareable, we are taking that Ursa Cine Immersive 16K HDR master and down converted it to 8K 60 frames per second SDR, the highest spec YouTube VR will accept. If you still see it pulling ahead here, imagine the gap inside Vision Pro at full resolution. We believe the next leap in immersive storytelling comes from accessibility, not exclusivity. This medium only involves if anyone can step inside, no matter the size of their gear budget. That's why you are getting this side-by-side in a format more viewers can actually watch today. Ursa Cine Immersive is a high-end, mission-focused camera. Canon solution is more attainable. Vision Pro is a premium. Plenty of you are on Quest, Pico, or desktop. You all deserve a fair look at what is possible. If you do own a Vision Pro, there's a link below to stream the untouched AI video file in our Spatial Film app or download it to evaluate a true 16K sharpness, HDR range, and 3D comfort for yourself. For everyone else, this YouTube version keeps the door open while we keep pushing the ceiling higher. Alright, the mission statement's done. Let's jump into the side-by-side VR 180 comparison and see which rig really holds up when you are inside the headset. First, let's start with the Canon R5C, 8K 60 frames per second RAW LT. The dual fisheye lens at its sharpness is f7.1. We are at ISO 800 to maximize dynamic range, 180 degree shutter for natural motion. These are the ideal settings to squeeze the best image quality out of the Canon in bright daylight. It is not true that Canon EOS VR does not support ND filters. It does. You can drop in a high quality in-sensor ND between the image sensor and the dual fisheye lens. And you should, to control exposure so you can keep optimal ISO, aperture, and shutter. Not as convenient as the built-in ND on the Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive, but it works and it does not hurt the image quality. I have a full review video right here if you want to dive deeper. First thing you probably notice with a lot of the Canon, or honestly, most VR 180 video on the internet, is sharpness or a slightly blurriness. If you like, your vision drop a couple of points. If you wear glasses, it's like taking them off. That is the baseline many people are used to. Now, pay attention to the lens flare on the Canon dual fisheye lens. We are shooting nearly into the sun. Lens flare is basically unavoidable in immersive 180 production. So having strong anti-flare coating on a fisheye is huge for 3D. And Canon really excels here. You barely notice the flare in stereo. It is subtle and it adds a touch of cinematic feeling instead of becoming a distraction. Now, let's look at the Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive. Immediately, you see the world with clarity, without that AI upscaled, overprocessed digital look that killed that cinematic feeling. The word cinematic got thrown around a lot on the internet, but to me, it means the most accurate representation of reality. Detail, texture, and depth that feel natural. If your image is overprocessed by AI denoising and digital sharpening, it starts to look synthetic and your subconscious knows it isn't real. As a visual storyteller, my goal is to keep you from noticing the medium at all, so you forget you are watching and just are in the scene. A blurry image constantly reminds viewers they are watching a video, no matter how good, how immersive the story is. as one of the biggest problems holding back our entire 3D warranty industry. But is it worth $30,000 just to get that clarity? Comment and let us know what you think. Now look left and right, there's almost no chromatic aberration, no purple or green fringes on the edges. You will also notice the Ursa Cine Immersive feels slightly wider horizontally than the Canon here. Lens is not removed yet here for you to clearly see it. The Ursa can also focus very close, kimchi is about 1 foot from the camera here. Just because you can focus that close doesn't mean you should, unless you want to make your viewer going cross-eyed. Last thing, flare on the Ursa Cine Immersive. See that isolated green dot on the chart? Unlike Canon's subtle bow flare, the Ursa gives a tighter, spotty ghost that can be distracting and unnatural in 3D space. This is the only real negative I found so far. Be mindful, don't aim directly at the sun if you can help it. And if you must, don't let that flare dot sit on your subject. It pulls attention and can create stereo eye strain. 3D plus a bright spot flare is a bad combo. Avoid it at all cost. For sh** and giggle, let's throw in the Insta360 X5 at 8K version Ursa Cine Immersive. There you go. What do you think? AI camera versus cinema camera. There's still a long way to go. You get what you pay for in this industry. And no amount of AI will rescue fundamentally soft and compromised source images. Now let's move into low light and less than ideal shooting condition. ISO 800 is a very common indoor baseline, so we will start there with the Canon.
Okay, we're testing the Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive Camera. It's a mouthful. Anyway, look at this test comparable to the Canon R5C. Okay, we're testing the Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive Camera. It's a mouthful. Anyway, look at this test comparable to the Canon R5C. This is ISO 1600 with low lighting. This is ISO 1600 with low lighting. This is an ISO test. And the ISO is at 3200. This is an ISO test, and the ISO is at 3200.
As you can tell, in challenging lighting, the Ursa Cine Immersive is way better than the Canon. It generally shows less noise at the exact same ISO settings. If you look at the neon size, you really see the dynamic range advantage. The highlight doesn't blow out into a flat block of color, and the shadow area don't turn into some dancing chroma noise. That balance, holding highlight detail and keeping shadow from getting ugly, is the power of a purposeful built cinema camera. There are a few other things we discovered during our testing. By the way, you can check out the final result right here, our full film on the Spatial Film app. It's free right now for educational use, so don't miss the chance to experiencing the full 16K 90 frames per second Apple Immersive Video inside your Apple Vision Pro. Now, let's talk about macro blocking. Here's the comparison. At bitrate 18:1, you can clearly see macro blocking artifacts, especially in low contrast and low light area. In 12:1, the image got noticeable clear. Macro blocking is reduced significantly. But when we push to 8:1 or even 5:1, we didn't see much additional improvement in image quality, while the file size increased significantly. So our recommendation is to stick to 12:1. It gives you the best balance between quality and manageable file size. We also learned that macro blocking is not just about raw compression. It can come from the rendering pipeline too. We found that adding a small amount of denoising before your color grading process can dramatically improve the final encoding in MVHDVC, even at ISO as low as 400s. If you have the time and budget, adding that denoising pass to clean up the raw before coloring is totally worth it. In our Santa Monica project, we didn't apply the step because rendering 16K 90 frames per second would have taken several extra days. But if you're working on a client project, make sure to plan ahead and budget for it. Trust me, it is a small step that makes a huge difference. Write this tip down. Another thing we noticed, the lens on the Ursa Cine Immersive doesn't seem to reach true infinity focus. Internet rumors suggest the lens is around f4 to f5.6 fixed, which makes it harder to achieve infinity. You can clearly see it here. The Pacific Rim in the distance, the wording Pacific Rim are soft and unreadable. There's a bit of cinematic depth of field happening right here, which is very different from what we used to on the Canon Dual Fisheye lens. So if your goal is to capture large, faraway landscape with sharp, distant detail, this isn't the camera for that. At that range, there's no 3D depth anyway, so you are better off using a single fisheye camera. So in conclusion, even though the Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive is a fantastic camera, it's not the right tool for every job. Know your story, know your shooting conditions, plan accordingly. Our mission here is to do the independent testing and real-world R&D for you, so you can master the creative process of immersive storytelling, no matter what your budget is. To support us and our original work, please consider subscribing if you are new here, share this video, drop a question or suggestion in the comments. Your feedback helps this community grow. And if you have a film project and want to work together, reach out. We are available for hire. If you are still learning, don't miss out our next tutorial on DaVinci Resolve. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.